Hi, and welcome to session 5 in our Coolselector deep dive sessions. Today, we'll talk about incompressible flow in valves. In last session, we developed an equation for the pressure drop in fittings, and let's just recap. What this equation said was that the pressure drop is equal to the resistance coefficient times the density, velocity squared, divided by 2. Now, we're going to rearrange this equation a bit, trying to solve it for the velocity. So we get that the velocity is equal to pressure drop divided by density times resistance coefficient. So now we have an expression for the velocity. Let's try to multiply with area on both sides of the equations. I'm gonna move up here. When you multiply the velocity with the area, you get the flow, or the volume flow rate. It's got the units cubic meters per second. Then you have the area, you have the square root of 2 divided by the resistance coefficient, and you have the square root of delta P divided by rho. This value here, we call AV, it's the flow coefficient. So we end up with an equation looking like this. And if you have ever worked with valves, you might recognize this equation. Now we are getting to something that you are used to look at. Normally, this flow coefficient is called KV, or if you are in the US, CV, but that's simply a matter of units. But we can create a table where we actually express what is the volume flow, what is the flow coefficient, what is the delta P over rho, depending on the unit system you actually use. So, the first one, that was this equation. Delta P, that's in Pascal. Density, cubic meters per kilograms. And the flow, cubic meters per second. Then you have the equations if you use the normal international units. Then you call the flow coefficient KV. And now for tradition, and because these equations were evolved, deducted in the 19th century, you used water all the time. So when you did measurements of KV values of valves, you did it on water, and then you took the density of the fluid you were going to use and divided it by the density of water where you measured. So this value, density 0 or rho 0, is just water at 20 degrees, so it's a density of 1,000 kilograms per cubic meters. If you use this equation, the pressure drop is expressed in bars. The density is still cubic meters per kilograms, and the flow is in cubic meters per hour. And then finally, this is the equation you use if you use US units. I'm not gonna write all the units here, but it's just CV instead of KV. So it's basically the same. So this equation here is what you could call the basic valve equation. Next time, we'll look at what happens when we go from incompressible flow to compressible flow, that is gas flow in valves, what the equation will look like then. Until then, you can download Coolselector on the Danfoss homepage. Thank you for watching.